God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Amen, my friends. Amen. A few announcements for you this morning. First of all, it looks like the screen's out of whack. You're welcome. Thank you so much to April Edney who made sure that we fixed the screen. So it's all the reading upside down on my right or left hand side. You're welcome. It's not why you have to stand on your head this side of the room. Y'all didn't think that was funny. I thought so. We'll move on. Secondly, then I think in trying to fix the screens, I unplugged, blame me, the sound system. So instead of fishing around for the plug right now, it's sort of 9 o'clock to get started. Again, you're welcome. Thirdly, this morning, we're going to change things up a bit. One of the things, the traps we can fall into in worship is we forget why we sing in the first place. Why do you sing hymns? Why do you sing praise songs in church? It's to praise God. And often in song, it reminds us of what we believe. So today, worship is going to be different compared to normal. If you're a guest today, I'm sorry, this is not the normal flow of things. But I'm not sorry about what we're going to do. We'll be doing a lot of singing. There will be interaction. For those of you who do not like singing, try to learn today. For those of you who do love singing, you're going to enjoy yourself. But let's be intentional about who we sing to in the midst of worship. Because it's not really about what I like. It's not really about what you like. It's for us to be growing closer to Jesus Christ. We've got a few announcements as well after that. So please bear with the screen as Alicia works frantically back here to fix it. What a gift as this thing went goofy between somewhere Thursday and this morning. And if you come here a lot, you realize that happens quite a bit here. We'll move on. This morning, I have a few announcements. First of all, we have guest cards in the pews. If you're a guest, we'd love for you to throw one of those cards out and drop it off in the offering plate. On the flip side of that guest card is our prayer card, because we are intentional about praying for each other, as you can see inside of your programs or your bulletins. Just drop those cards off in the offering plate on your way out, right by where Dale was handing out programs this morning. Also, there's no youth group tonight. Our youth, instead, we were supposed to go ice skating. We ended up going bowling last night, so that's what youth groups tonight is off for youth. Meanwhile, our 4th through 6th grader overnighter at Wesley Woods is this weekend. If your youngster is going on this trip, I need to know as soon as possible to make sure Wesley Woods knows that we have enough spots, okay? That's this Friday, 4 p.m. through Saturday, 4 p.m., $25 cost or whatever the flyer said. I think it's even less than that. Just get in touch with me if your youngster's going. Coming up as well, backpack program will be filling backpacks on May 1st as well as May 9th here at the church at 1:30 p.m. If you're interested in helping feed kids for the weekend, where this is a private thing where the kids don't know who the food came from, and also too, quite simply, kids. It's not a public thing about who gets food and whatnot. It's a way to help kids who don't have enough food for the weekend. If you're interested in helping, that's both May 1st and May 9th, 1:30 p.m. here at the church. Next up, the ladies' blue jeans banquet is May 16th at 6:30 p.m. here at the church. Details are inside the programs on the barely seen flyer. Again, it's a bad joke. Y'all, I know, we're all waking up today. On your fluorescent yellow. Check out those details if you're so inclined to come. My goodness, is my handwriting bad this morning. Let's see, archery tag, that's what that is. Thanks, Alicia. Archery tag is coming up May 19th, that Saturday's makeup for when the field was way too wet for us to go last month, or this month, I should say. So if you're a young adult excited to go, come on and check that out. Archery tag, May 19th. If you have any questions that you've been afraid to ask, you don't think are worthy of asking in church or whatnot, but you want an answer to, we'll discuss those over the summer for a summer series on the questions we were supposedly afraid to ask. Just make sure you drop in those suggestions to me, whether by email, Facebook, calling the church, sliding a note under my door, whatever it might be. We'd love to know what you want to know. So we're going to look at that this summer. Finally, thank you. I was able to leave here for a week. I've been a pastor for 13 years, a youth minister for 7 years. I've never been in a place until I arrived here where I felt safe to leave. You have been such a gift. One, to have Nick Carlson, let alone the incredible staff we have here at the church, who can fill in and cover. What a gift. Two, you as people. I was able to go away. I didn't feel like there was something that was going to blow up, fall apart while I was gone. What a gift you are. So I just need to say thank you. Friends, let's greet one another with the love of Christ.
Guys, we're in Tiger.
So let's do that together as we sing together. First of all, bless that wonderful name. As best as it may be on the screen, well done. Thank you. Let's sing together.
Clear more. and other creatures. In order to do this, attend strictly to the sense of what you say, and see that your heart is not higher than your ways, but offer to God continually. So shall you esteem such as the Lord will approve here, and reward you when he cometh in the clouds of heaven.
My friends, please be seated if you haven't fallen asleep. That was in a 1761 copy of Methodist or Select Hymns is what the technical name is. I read through that hymnal. We don't sing many of those songs anymore. A few Isaac Watts, the old Rugged Cross, I think was one of them, and a few Charles Wesley hymns. Those are the ones I recognize. There weren't a lot that we keep singing, but that's also 250 years ago. What we can get from that is, when you sing, who do you sing to? The person next to you? No. Yourself? No. Make sure other people can hear you? No. It's really to sing unto God. So we don't crawl on, we don't get too loud, we don't hide ourselves, we don't sing as though we're at a funeral. We also don't sing to make sure that we're the fastest person there. It's really to sing unto God. Hopefully you heard that in the midst of it all. So as we worship today, we want to make sure that we're intentional about how we sing, even more so who we sing to. With that being in mind, we're going to remind ourselves of how we're called to worship as it is. And so, why don't we pray together before our scripture reading this morning. Take from Psalm 150. Accept. Karen. Is that you?
Yeah.
Come on up. I thought it was you. You know, it'd be nice if we prayed before. Wow. Friends, you're a guest today. You don't want to know how much I've missed this part. Let's pray together. Lord,
open our hearts and minds by the power of the Holy Spirit. And as the scriptures are read and the word is proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen.
The first reading this morning is taken from Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with the timbrel and dancing. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Friends, this is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
It's time for our children's message. If our youngest folks would like to come forward, that would be a great thing. Hey, Alicia, do you mind going back to Psalm 150, like the last verse there? We're on the screen. Morning, Rachel. Morning, Silas. Morning, Dennis. Morning, Ellen. Morning, Bailey. Good morning, Riley. Good morning, Jenny. Good morning, Annie. Do you hear all those different musical instruments that we were supposed to sing with? Did you hear that? Yeah. Right. You're right. Praise him. Well, you know, I'm going to go up here. We've got some funky words here, so let me grab this right there. I don't remember all of them off the top of my head. But I have the wrong sheet of paper, so that won't help either. We'll move on. All right, so Alicia, do you mind going to verse 2? Thanks. At least she can cover for me. Yeah, I know. A little goofy. Verse 3 then, praise him with the trumpets. Everybody brought the trumpets today? No trumpets? My neighbors when I was growing up were very thankful when I didn't quit playing the trumpet because it sounded like a bugle was passing away in our house. Also, after the trumpet though, praise him with the harp and the lyre. Who here has a lyre? I said, who has a lyre, not who is a lyre? A lyre is this ancient, almost four-string guitar slash harp looking thing. Harps back in their day were also portable, so they'd be heavier but had more strings to them. That's my guess. Rough thing. Moving on, praise him with the timbrel. You guys all have timbrels and all?
No.
No. They're pretty much tambourines. Praise him with the strings and pipe. You guys have a pipe?
No.
No?
You may soon.
No, yeah, but praise him with the cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals, which means almost every musical instrument they had when this was written around 2,500 to 3,000 years ago use them. Whenever you get in worship, you ought to use them. So guess what I have for you today?
What?
Musical instruments.
Yay! Guess what? Everybody in the sanctuary here today. Musical instruments. Remain seated. Y'all look way too excited. Here's what we have. We have here, Alicia, if you don't mind going to the slide at the picture after the introduction of the Lord's message. As a picture of some of the instruments we have up there. We've got noisemakers, we've got flutes, and we have a few other things. Not that we have leftovers from Palm Sunday, but we even have them. Alright, you guys are... Well, that one's broken, no wonder. That's better. Leftovers from Palm Sunday. Can you help me pass these out?
Yeah.
Thank you. Here we go. I have four buckets total. How about we have two of you with this bucket here? Who wants to go? How about? I'm going to go like this. Thaddeus and Silas, you mind taking this? Why don't you go on down that? You want to go on this side? You okay with that? All right. Who do you take with you? All right. You okay with that, Ben? Can you keep an eye on Bailey for me? Work more, Bailey. Keep an eye on Addie for me. All right, ladies. You want to work? There you go. We'll just see how well this works. You guys on this side, you're okay? Addie, you're good to work. You want to go? And then Emily, Rachel, over there. Make sure everybody gets one. They're going to love it. All right, you know what? Jenna and Riley, they decided to do wrong thing. Go over and break this up. Thank you. Everybody gets one. Choose what you like. Karen, you read so well this morning. You want my broken one? Oh yeah. Wait, we have some real musicians up here. You know, maybe I should show more discretion with who gets the flutes. I'm just saying. Cows from across the county. That's not the point. But as best you can, let's let's worship God together with all the instruments we have. Let's sing together or play together. This is the day. God.
Thanks be to God.
So as soon as we confess our sins to God, it's as though he's moved them as far as east is from the west. It's as though they are buried in the ocean and not to be seen anymore. It's as though the whiteboard's been wiped and we are now cleansed. Thanks be to God for his incredible grace that we see in Jesus Christ. So let's celebrate. Let's sing together. Bless his holy name. Number, we'll just sing together, don't worry.
Thank you.
that maybe God desires that more than what's in our wallets or other gifts we have, but that should sing with joy. Let alone when you leave here today, to be filled with joy. Now, of course, if you hate singing, this may not be the Sunday you feel so happy when you walk out. But joy is different than happiness. Happiness is a momentary emotion. I knew joy in the midst of my dad's terminal diagnosis with cancer and the day of his funeral service. I didn't know much happiness, but I knew joy. Joy is connected to Jesus Christ, the one who's conquered death. Happiness is things are going my way. There is a difference. Thanks be to God. Because life with him is troubles. But Jesus has overcome the greatest. At this point, let's sing together our doxology. If it's in there, I'm not sure Alicia if it's there or not.
Summer had a little baby boy on Wednesday. His name is Tanner Craig. So that now gives my dad 12 great-grandchildren.
Wonderful. Now, Tanner, I didn't catch Tanner's middle name.
Tanner Craig, after my husband.
Cindy, thank you. you. Abigail.
Asking for prayers for the Kennedy family in Erie, the death of their mother.
So that's for the Kennedy family in Erie. All right, we missed their death with their mom. Abigail, thank you. Friends, is there anything else we need to be praying for, thank God for, praise God for who God is? Bonnie.
Thank you, Jack, for mercy for my daughter this weekend. She's out there across the road.
She's driving mercies for your daughter. Thanks, Bonnie. Michelle's okay, I bring up and light your shoulder. Okay, just checking. I'm far too glad I did it publicly. Michelle separated her shoulder. This has not been an easy recovery, so let's be praying for Michelle as well. And this is her shoulder. Is it separation?
It's fractured.
Fractured? Oh, you don't do anything small scale. I slightly separated my shoulder trying to break up a hockey fight 2 decades ago, and I still feel it most of the time. But then the doctor told me that 2 decades ago, and I was like, yeah, whatever. I should have listened to him. So, let's be praying for Michelle that she doesn't have the issues I have, and mine are not that bad. It's just arthritis. But arthritis shows up much more than you think. Also, my friends, be praying for TJ Mills, or I'm sorry, TJ Gill, pardon me. Who is on hospice care. If you know TJ, TJ is on hospice care. That's from Nellie Mount this morning. Friends, is there anything else? Then, let's go to the Lord together in prayer. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him above and below. Father, whether it's the angels in heaven or our measly voices here, we give you praise this morning because you are worthy. The God of heaven and earth, who created us in the first place, who made us in your image, and yet in the midst of our fall, you sent your son Jesus to die in our place. That without Jesus Christ, there is no hope, but because Jesus rose from the dead and paid the price for our sins, now we are filled with hope. We thank you and we praise you for your incredible love for us. How do you make what is in creation is beyond our comprehension? How do you make the grass grow after this long in the winter? I kill plants in the house after a few weeks. You are the one who brings them back constantly. How do you provide for the birds of the air? How do you care for us in so many different ways that you do? The intricacies of how our bodies are wired together, blood flow and oxygen being transmitted through our lungs. How do you make these things happen, Father? We get excited by a new car that human hands have made. You're the God who made the cheetah out of nothing. Father, you are worthy of praise. We thank you for the incredible gifts you've given us in life. We thank you for our families, for our children, for our grandchildren, for our great-grandchildren. How you bless us with so many people in our midst here this morning that care for us and that we can love. We give you thanks, Father, that worship is not so connected to the audiovisual things we might have that too easily can go haywire, let alone how our bodies might begin to fail. Our hope is placed in you. In your son Jesus, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. We thank you, Father, for how we've seen your hand at work. For Tanner Craig, Cindy's grandson, Tucker's great-grandson, we praise you. We thank you, Father, for moving and working in the Means family's life and the midst of their being able to sell the motorhome and how you provide. Father, we've seen your hand at work for traveling mercies for so many of us. Follow the rest that you blessed me with in the midst of the vacation to see family and go to Disney. Thank you. We're asking, Father, for you to move more in our midst as well. That you be bringing about healing and comfort for the T.J. Gill's family, let alone T.J. Gill. We ask, Father, to bring about healing upon Michelle and this ability to persevere through the pain in the midst of her fractured shoulder, but we're asking, Father, for healing in Jesus' name. We come before you, Father, asking that you be with Bonnie's daughter in the midst of her traveling. Well, the traveling that so many of our family members are undergoing. We're asking, Father, that you be with the Kennedy family in the midst of their loss and their mother. We're asking for your Holy Spirit, bring about comfort and peace. Father, there are so many things going on in our midst. As you are worthy for us to give you this sacrifice of praise. We thank you and praise you as we praise Jesus, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Friends, if you're a skipper for following the bulletin, you'll notice that I skipped the song. You don't have to look, just trust me. Skip number 405, seek ye first in our hymnals. So, Alicia, incredible work this morning. Thank you. Let's sing together, seek ye first the kingdom of God.
Thank you.
if you would, please be seated. Your assignment for this week, you can find your programs, and Alicia's done a great job this morning keeping ahead. You don't even want to know how difficult it is to re-space everything on the screen when it gets out of black like this. Thanks to God for the gift that Alicia is that she's willing to go through this logging this morning. Here's your assignment that we're giving this morning. Choose to intentionally praise God this week. Whether it's a song, it's work, it's service, wherever it may be. It might be at work, 9 to 5, and then suddenly you get change in your head. Where I remember the day where I was working in the turnpike as a toll collector and realized I was worshiping God by how I collected tolls. And then I had co-workers there yelling at me because I was too nice to the people who drove through as I collected their change. I was too nice. Because it wasn't about them, it was about Jesus. Wherever it may be, you may catch yourself singing in the shower, warn your family, make sure that you're all right. You may catch yourself singing in the car. Don't worry, people will look at you strangely because you're not singing for them. Whatever it might be, somehow worship God this week. Then tell someone from church today what you did. It's one thing to do it privately. Something beautiful happens when we're willing to share. Try not to be arrogant about it. Try not to also be so humble that you act as though you're Eeyore talking about such a thing. But tell someone what you did. That's your sign for this week. Psalm 34 is our final reading this morning. Take them from verses 1 through 3. My friends, this is the word of the Lord. I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Amen. And so let's sing together the glory of Patria. If you don't know what that is, we're singing the 11 o'clock service. We'll just mess through it. We already got it before, didn't we? That's all right. Let's stand together as we sing together.
Thank you.
short service and tell someone about how you worship this week. Let's pray together. I encourage you as we pray to turn your hand up toward heaven and talk with God. Repeat after me. If you'd like to read the prayer that's on the screen behind you, well, let's pray. Lord God, loving Father,
I love you.
I praise you, God.
I praise you, God.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Thank you for forgiveness and all that you do.
Thank you for forgiveness and all that you do.
Move in my life.
Move in my life.
I sing your praises.
I sing your praises.
Lord, you are praiseworthy.
Lord, you are praiseworthy.
I praise you in Jesus' name.
I praise you in Jesus' name.
Praising my Savior all the day long. My friends, as you leave here today, may the Lord bless you and keep you. You know, this is a little distracting, isn't it? Think about it. It's not about us being the norm for church. It's really about who it's all about. The main thing is the main thing. His name is Jesus. As you leave here today, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and joyfully give you peace. Amen. And amen. Thank you.